place like California. California, A-A-T-L-M-I-A-D-M-V. All reminds me of California, cause there's no place like California. California, A.
New York, Texas, Midwest, it all reminds me of California, cause there's no place like California. California, A.
Got some out in Dallas, now I'm smelling like LA. Met a from Miami to the Machiavelli. Left the kids on the belly, left the vid on my celly. She ate like spaghetti, I'm hitting gas and dready. Met some killers in Memphis, like they from Oakland. Give me my flowers while I can smell them. Ain't talking about roses, literally I'm lean. Mix it like a bought it in Nashville. Then I woke up in Tulsa, Oklahoma, it's sunny. California, but nothing like Compton. It's more like Calistoga and it's hot as Arizona. I pop me a Fresno, hard colder than Minnesota in October. Don't interrupt, dog, I'm in the zone. Why does everywhere I go just remind me of home? You know that state of gold with the bed. Them other places come close, but they don't compare.
Now I've been in New York, come on, Texas, yeah, Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A-A-T-L-M-I-A-D-M-V. All reminds me of California, cause there's no place like California. California, eh?
California, no place like California.
Fresh off a flight to Boston, got a BZ in Maryland that I pipe too often. Headed right to Austin, most likely flossing. Tight, exhausted, high as a forklift. Handful of goons out in Colorado. Any given afternoon, you can catch a hollow. Honestly, it's the same out in Richmond, Virginia or California. Either state, you can get it. I done seen everywhere from Russia to Delaware, trust me, I'm well aware. Barcelona to Bel Air, Petty to the Detroit. Don't tell him he saw how heavily he balls. Every project, every seashore, and I ain't content trying to see more. Nomadic.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today, trying to push their team to victory. It's the Rams going up against the Bears. With that, let's send it out to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis, with this Week 2 matchup.
First opened way back in 1924, but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Today, after a crazy opening weekend, it's on to Week 2, and we've got a good one here between the Los Angeles Rams and the Chicago Bears. Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. The offense on your screen now, and Todd Gurley on your screen. That is the back of the present and the future.
And what an amazing return for him from a knee injury his last year in college at the University of Georgia. Now it's like it never happened. There's nothing he can't do on the football field. And if you're a defense, that's a long day trying to prepare for Todd Gurley.
It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And they talked about how important the passing game was going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation. It's all about planning. And then it's about execution. So they put it all together in practice. Okay, this is what we think we're going to see. This is how they get to it. And then when the game comes, read it and attack it.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
And here's a look at the defensive unit that hopes to halt this offense today. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down.
Here we go now.
On 2nd down, here's Goff. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets them a new set of downs.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Back to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down of the sack. Second down, this is Gurley. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. A four-yard pickup that gets him going forward, but still 15 yards left on third down. The seventh play now of this opening drive. This is third and long, though. They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because, really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
So our initial drive here this afternoon results in three. I'm not sure that was a statement necessarily, but getting points on the road, never a bad thing.
No question about it, Brandon. You had a crowd that was all fired up during pregame introductions, yet you're able to quiet them just a little bit by taking the early lead.
One receiver right is Watkins. They go play action here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket and incomplete to open things up. And we get a peek at the offense and a peek at Alshon Jeffrey.
An absolute matchup nightmare for any defensive back. Size, speed, terrific hands.
And on second and 10 now. They'll give it to him right up the gut. He takes this for three to the 29. The starters on defense here for Los Angeles.
Michael Brockers was a first-round pick coming out of college and has done nothing but enhance that status. A tremendous player inside.
It's third down, 6 yards to go for the offense. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's got Watkins on the out route. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. First down coming there on the intermediate passing play. That's been a point of emphasis, they told us in practice, using those medium routes to keep the defense off balance.
And it wasn't just them telling us. We got to watch them practice it and work on it because they've been trying to fine-tune it and get it right before this game. And I think they have to be happy with the result.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39. On the stop was Aaron Donald.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Flex round! Let's go!
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And Jeffrey's got it! And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab.
Let's go! White 90!
They'll look to throw here on first down, and that's incomplete. Sammy Watkins, the intended receiver, that'll bring up second down.
had a coach tell me a long time ago that running a screen pass is similar to acting 101 for your offense, because you've got to show something different and create extra space for linemen to chase the quarterback in order to create extra room for the receiver to catch the football and maneuver upfield. In this case, though, give a lot of credit to the defense. They communicated well. You could hear them talking to each other on the field, and they reacted and knocked it away. This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
They'll go to the air here on third and two. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. A three-yard gain and enough for the first down.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Jeffrey with a catch left side. It's a 9-yard gain and it keeps the drive moving.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And it'll be taken down here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. Brandon Gauden, Charles Davis back with you as it's Bears football here to begin quarter number two. They've got a second down and 5 here to start things out. And this seemingly endless drive continues. Shotgun. He'll look to throw. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height. Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does, where a quarterback has to slide and find open space to throw.
And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Now, that's the defense that they were looking for, being able to get extra bodies to the point of attack to deal with the big guy carrying the ball. You really don't want to be in a position where it's a one-on-one tackle with him.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
They're going to look to throw, and they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. Call it a loss of 5, a big sack to bring up third down. The defense in an enviable position here. The offense needs 13 yards. It's third down. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Call it a loss of 4 there on the sack. And speaking of the number 4, it brings up fourth down now. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will tie us at 3-3. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
As the kick's away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game
are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he did not knock down.
Here's Gaughan. He's going to rifle one deep left side. He's got a man complete. A very solid gain of 27.
When I watched Jared Goff on tape at Cal, I saw a guy who wasn't just a dart thrower. You know, a lot of people said, he's perfect for the West Coast offense. I always thought he could do a little bit more, and that was the reason why. He can push it downfield. He has a good, strong arm.
Hurry up, here we go.
On first down, it's gone. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and it'll be second and very short. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
The defense came out with a look that they had prepped for all week to attack. They took advantage, got the first down.
And the key words in there, prepped for all week. They really studied them. Understood their tendencies, knew what they liked to do, and prepared their game plan accordingly. And boy, the payoff was good. I don't know about you, but I wanted to reach out of the booth and snatch that pass myself. That thing floated forever up there. I think that threw off the timing of the receiver. That's why he couldn't get his feet down, even though he caught the ball.
You know, Charles, I would have liked to have seen. Now a battle for the football. It's caught. It's their dangerous wide receiver. His first NFL reception goes for six. And the Rams have taken the lead. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Onto the field now come the Bears. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out now joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
And maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. Michael Brockers in on the stop. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there and swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Looking for Watkins, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. A 1 yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. So holding by the offense and maybe now got to shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook. But, boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
And now we're circling here around the two-minute warning.
This is a setup play, trying to get one last one in before the clock warning.
Here's Goff now on second down. And he will find his big tight end over the middle.
A good pickup there, a 22. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Soldier Field following this short break. Now a first down throw, gone. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it'll be second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
Quick hitter here, it's complete. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
3 yards to go here on second down. On second down, here's Goff. Flush to his right. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down. The Bears have put an extra defender in the secondary on third down.
Yep, they're in the nickel. Goff now looks to throw, and he can't quite intercept it. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. And his kick is right there. It's good. And they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now the Bears' offense ready to take over again. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And quickly, they get to the line.
Come on, let's go! White, 90!
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete. Short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
He'll field this at the 5. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And possession will change here with very little time remaining until halftime. First down, gone. Flushed out right. And he'll avoid the... Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Back there, Philly. Here we go. Hurry up now. Lock it
to the ground, this time with Gurley. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game, as we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And they will not get a chance to return this one, as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So here's the Bears' offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I've never wanted to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is a I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Now they'll run it on the toss. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give them a new set of downs.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. So it'll be first down here after the run. One receiver right, that's Jeffrey. They go play action here on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
I think we need to come up with a different name for this position. We keep calling it the fullback position. That doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback, but we know this. Whoever's coming out of that spot is usually bigger and stronger, and they may not run away from people, but they'll run through them.
Yeah, able to shed tacklers. We saw it right there. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling.
Third and inches, just turn around, hand it to the big guy and let him plow forward and pick up a first down. A lot of people think that the offensive line, they may almost take the play off because they got a big guy back there pushing forward. I think it actually works in reverse. I think they block harder because they love seeing that guy get the ball because he doesn't touch it very often.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll get across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. He's going to let this one go deep. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Well, they decide to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. One receiver right, that's Jeffrey. Third down, he'll drop to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? You're able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Now a play fake here on first down. He'll hit Watkins on the crossing route. And they do get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Let Although go, they won't get the same go. Credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Second and goal to go now. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3.
Well, sometimes I get caught in hyperbole, but I think they desperately need to punch this one in. They're running out of time.
Yeah, 2-score game, second half. You're down here. This is the time to put it in the end zone.
Man, not going to get much better than this for an opportunity.
From the 3 now, here they come on 3rd and goal. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. They'll look to throw on 3rd and goal. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. It's the fullback. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Bears have cut it to within a score. And he puts it through. They're within 3. It's 13-10. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Is fielded at the 2. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. The one running back is Gurley. And he'll get it up the middle. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave him good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing. And they did it behind a 2 tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the 2 tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one.
That's caught inside the 20. And he takes this thing down deep into Chicago territory.
When the big guy rumbles down the center of the field and he gains leverage on a guy trying to cover him, it is really, really tough for the defender to get through him to make a play on the football. That's why guys love to throw that route down the middle, throw it deep, and let the big guy go get it.
And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackle was there right away for a loss of yardage.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line. Watch here. Press high. Coverage look defensively.
All right, here we go. Green, 39. Leopard. All right, here we go.
On second down, here's Goff. Escaping the pressure right. Going right side here, and that's complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Back now at Soldier Field. Been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the 4th quarter. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming from the left hash. A chip shot here. And his kick is indeed good. And that will add 3 more to their lead. It pushes it up to 6. So they get the 3 here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten 6 out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
And now the Bears coming out as they get ready. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. It goes as a gain of eight that moves the chains.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
It's a five receiver set, three to the left, two to the right.
Here we go! One, nine, five.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Wide open receiver complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. They'll get 32 yards there. And it'll be a Chicago first down. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Come on, let's go!
They'll look to throw here on first down. The looting, and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. A loss of four that time on the sack, and it brings up second.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and it can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
Over the middle, he's got Watkins. 23 yards on the play. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
Play, and it'll bring up a third down.
Well, the stats that matter on this play don't help a team very much unless, of course, you're playing defense.
If you're getting points per reception, you got a reception, but yeah. No yardage. Great job by the defense, though. They read through that one.
They read through it, gave up no yardage, and people got credit for tackles. Pretty good deal.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one.
Let's go!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. His pass caught at the four. Give him six on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. They come out with one back and three tight ends. It's a court, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. It's their quarterback. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Bears are an extra point away from taking the lead in this game. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The one running back is Gurley. He'll get the football here. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
He'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and eight.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in the old days were often outside linebackers. They just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the quarterback or the running backs quicker than ever before.
Desperation time for Goff on fourth. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. This remains a one-point game. The defense did their job. Now the offense here late, they just need to kind of hold on, seal this victory.
And the defense did it so well, didn't they? Didn't allow any points and got the ball back for their offense in order to close out this game. What a great feeling for both sides of the ball.
It'll be a better feeling if the offense can just seal this thing. We'll see if they can do it.
You trying to say the defense doesn't want to go back out there again?
That's correct.
Okay.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Taken down at the 34. Trying to run some clock with Langford, and he's able to get it. And the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. And Bailey able to knock it through, and they add on and get a little bit of a cushion. It's 20-16 now. So a good kick there, and they wrap up the drive by putting three on the board.
And you know, let's face it, you're not always going to come away with six. Defense in the NFL are just too good. But you've got to come away with something. And there, they get three.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Offense now making their way out to take over. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure.
Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Now the offense lining up first and 10.
Good. Here we go. 3-19. Back down to that Philly. Here we go. Hurry up. Here we go.
Back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's brought down. Got a little handsy there, defensive holding, Charles.
And defenders will get away with as much as you will allow. The 5-yard mark tells the officials where the line should be drawn.
So here we go, first and 10 now.
All right, here we go.
They'll look to throw. And he will find his man on the outside.
It's a gain of 17 that time. And it'll be a Los Angeles first down. And he did exactly what they needed him to do, Charles. Got out of bounds. They have no timeouts.
And they knew that before the play even began. Still executed it. How many times have we seen it happen where you know it, yet a guy's still looking for a timeout?
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Cornell McPhee in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
One last throw here for Goff. And this is incomplete. So no miracles here on the final play. And this ball game is over. Well, Charles, they were close.